Many people believe in God. In what sense? They believe that there must exist a God, a creator. Sheer logic causes them to believe this. Why? Because of being aware that there is creation. If the creator would not exist, no creation would exist. Why? Because nothing comes from nothing. This is also why we know that God has always existed. If there would have been a time when he did not exist, then nothing would exist today. The fact that creation exists proves there must be a creator. It also shows that God exists from all eternity, although with our imperfect human mind, we have a hard time grasping this. We are the product of his creation. But is it enough to believe in him as the creator? Because without creator, there could be no creation? No. Is it enough for a child to believe he has a father? Because without father, he would not exist? No. A child should love his father. A father normally loves and cares for his children. Please turn with me to Ephesians chapter 3. Jehovah can and will intervene positively in your life. Notice what it says at Ephesians 3 verse 20. Now to the one who can, according to his power that is operating in us, do more than superabundantly beyond all the things we ask or conceive. The expression, his power that is operating in us, is this not something very encouraging and faith-strengthening? His power is not just operating in us, but operating in us superabundantly. No, but more than superabundantly, beyond what we can envision or comprehend.
Well, Gerrit, you've certainly superabundantly failed in those arguments for God. I mean, really, that was playground stuff. First of all, he says,
if the creator would not exist, no creation would exist. Why? Because nothing comes from nothing.
Yes, nothing comes from nothing, apart from God. God comes from nothing. He's just always been here. He's always existed. Everything else must be subject to this logic that nothing comes from nothing. If it's there, it must have had an origin. It must have had a creator. But the one exemption to this logic, because it suits theists, is God. Even Gerrit seems to acknowledge the double standard in this argument.
God exists from all eternity. Although with our imperfect human mind, we have a hard time grasping this.
Yes, it's our imperfect human minds. We have a hard time grasping this. God doesn't need a beginning. Everything else does. Just take it from me, Gerrit Lösch, governing body member, who relies on your belief in God, specifically your belief in Jehovah and what Jehovah requires in order to have the prominence and position that I enjoy. Then he hits us with a second appalling argument.
Is it enough for a child to believe he has a father? Because without father he would not exist? No. A child should love his father. The father normally loves and cares for his children.
The father normally loves and cares for his children. Apart from those many, many cases where the father doesn't love and care for his children. In fact, we've heard in this very convention an example of a father running away when he first learned that his wife was pregnant. I'm sure that happens all the time. I'm also sure that there are cases where fathers and indeed mothers are abusive. Just because you're a parent doesn't mean your child is required to love you. That's not a reasonable demand that you can make of a child. Gerrit Lösch doesn't know this, because he's never been a father. In fact, the only one on the governing body who has children is Anthony Morris, which when you consider how much advice the governing body dole out to parents is actually quite disheartening. And I realise you don't have to be a parent to know stuff. You don't have to be a parent to know that love isn't automatic for children. But I think this is an area in which Gerrit Lösch's lack of life experience is showing. His naivety and ignorance is shining through here. You simply cannot say that a child ought to love its parents. It's a rubbish analogy aimed at persuading people to believe in God. And let's not forget, it's not just about belief in God, which I think is what Gerrit Lösch is saying here. There's more to it than that. It's all about following God's requirements, obeying God, obeying the requirements that Gerrit Lösch and his associates insist are those of God. So it's actually much more specific, isn't it? And we can see why Gerrit Lösch benefits personally from people not just believing in God, but believing specifically that Gerrit and his associates are God's faithful slave, his channel with mankind.